Today, we're going to be talking about how to properly rack and stack a Nutanix block. This is meant to be a demonstration of the most common hardware. However, there are some slight differences between generations, as well as the differences between a 1 and 2U chassis. Today, we're going to be talking about how to properly rack a 2U chassis. Let's get started. When you're doing a Nutanix installation, here's what you'll want to bring with you. A laptop with VirtualBox. You can also use VMware Workstation / Fusion. A 16 or 24 port 1 gig layer 2 network switch. Ethernet cables. You should bring at least one cable per node, as well as one for the laptop. The power cable supplied with your Nutanix block to allow you to plug into the rack's PDU. A power strip for the laptop and switch. You may need a power conversion adapters for international outlets. Foundation VM and or Foundation Discovery Java applet. An SSH client. My go-to is PuTTY, however there are quite a few. Now, while all of that is essential, in some special cases, you will need SFPs for nodes with no 1 gig ports on them. For example, the NX3175. The IPMI view tool from Supermicro, if you need to make any BIOS updates. WinSCP, if you need to move files to and from the Foundation VM. When you unpack your Nutanix block, you'll find yourself with the block itself, with all the disks and nodes installed, the rail kit, and enough power cables matching the number of PSUs in your block. Before we actually mount a Nutanix block, consider the weight. You may need a friend to help lift it in the rack. Also, please ensure your server room has proper power requirements as well as good ventilation. You'll find more information on these items as well as specific instructions for different rail kits available on the Nutanix support portal in the Nutanix Rack Mounting Guide. First, find your rails. Note, there is a left and a right one. Next, you need to separate the inner rail from the outer rail. Pull the inner rail out until it clicks in place, fully extended. Then, press and hold the locking tab down. This releases the inner rail. Continue pulling the inner rail out until it's fully separated. If you have a newer simplified rail kit, there is no inner rail to separate. We'll cover this kit a little later. Each inner rail is labeled with L and R, indicating its side on the blocks as you look at the front. Start by placing an inner rail against the side of the block. The front of the inner rail lines up with the block like this. Line up the hooks on the side of the block with the square holes in the inner rail. Slide the inner rail forward until it clicks. Repeat these steps for the other side. Now, for each outer rail, depress the locking tab and push the middle rail back into the outer rail to collapse. Then, hang the hooks of the front of the outer rail into the slots on the front of the rack. Ensure the spring-loaded pegs snap into the square slots. Pull out the rear of the outer rail, adjusting the length until it fits within the posts of the rack. Hang the hooks of the rear portion of the outer rail onto the slots on the rear side of the rack. Ensure the spring-loaded pegs snap into the square slots. As we mentioned before, the simplified rail process is a little different. Push the small hooks on the front section of the rail into the holes on the front post of the rack and press down. Ensure the spring-loaded pegs snap into the square slots. Pull out the rear section of the outer rail. Adjust the rail length until it fits within the posts of the rack. Be sure the rail is level and ensure the spring-loaded pegs snap into the rack's holes. Now it's time to mount the block. This isn't something you want to do alone. Use a server lift or at least get one other person to help you. Pull the middle rail from the outer rail until it locks in an extended position. Align the inner rails mounted on the chassis with the middle rails. Slide the inner rails into the ball bearing shuttle on the middle rails until the locking tab of the inner rail clicks into place. Press the inner rail locking tabs down simultaneously and push the chassis into the rack. If necessary, secure the front of the chassis to the rack with the thumb screws. Slide the chassis into the rack. The bottom of the chassis slides onto the bottom lip of the rails. Secure the front of the chassis to the rack with the thumb screws. The last thing we need to do is connect our power and network cables to prepare for the foundation process. Connect each node to your switch by plugging into the shared gigabit Ethernet port and connecting it to the Layer 2 switch. Refer to the hardware documentation for identifying shared port for your model. Make sure to connect your laptop into the same switch. Do not yet plug into the production network until the initial configuration is completed. Finally, we'll take the power cords and plug them into our block and press the power button on the front of each node. And that's it. Your Nutanix block is now racked, and your nodes are ready for the foundation process.